They're the hottest group in the neighbourhood, five young men from Massachusetts. And although they've been performing now for 7 years, they still call themselves New Kids on the Block. Their arrival in Australia confirms their superstar status, with scenes reminiscent of the hysteria surrounding the Bay City Rollers tour of the 70s. And at their Sydney hotel, more fans waiting for a precious glimpse of Jonathan, Jordan, Joe, Donnie and Danny.
No, we're only screaming because we want to attract their attention. Yeah. We are not going to rip their clothes off. And if you're trying to keep us down, we're gonna come right back.
It's been a phenomenal rise. New Kids on the Block were created by former Prince producer Maurice Starr in 1985, when they really were kids, all aged between 13 and 17. Since then, they haven't looked back. The New Kids are now the highest paid act in the United States, outstripping even Madonna and Michael Jackson. 20 million album sales and last year's earnings at $115 million. But it's been well earned. They're regarded as one of the hardest working groups in the States, performing and recording virtually non-stop. The group has a widespread appeal, clean-cut boys performing a light rap dance mix. They've campaigned against drugs and perform at benefit concerts. Wholesome and pure, a surefire way to win parents' approval as much as their kids.
The charge of arson one carries a potential 20 years to life penalty.
But signs that clean image has started to crack. Last year, Donnie Wahlberg was arrested and charged with arson after allegedly creating a hotel fire with a bottle of vodka in Louisville.
Is this thing being blown out of proportion?
Yes, sir. Very much so.
And there have been rumors of wild hotel room parties with groupies. All denied, of course. But it seems to have done little to change the fans' minds.
You go up to some people, I mean anybody in the music business, and you try to come near them, people are going to push you back and make you feel like scum. But when it comes to New Kids on the Block, I mean, they make you feel a little bit worth, you know, something. And I appreciate them, and I don't want to see him get 10 years in jail for something he didn't do. I mean, they mean a lot to us.
New Kids on the Block promise Australian fans a concert to remember. And today they took time out to talk about fame, fortune and their future.
You've had a pretty big reaction from Australian fans. Does that attention from fans ever get too much?
It gets crazy, but I mean, you know, it's just the price you have to pay, you know what I mean? We're not going to complain about it and say, you know, tell the fans to stop enjoying themselves and stop showing their affection for us. I mean, if that's the only price we have to pay is having girls chase us around the streets, then I'll pay that price for another 10 years, you know.
But some of you have complained that sometimes it's almost like sexual harassment.
Oh, no, not sexual harassment. I mean, you know, when they sneak into your room and you're standing there, you know, trying to take a shower and, you know, you get caught in predicaments like that, sure, it gets aggravating, but, you know, just, hey. I mean, there's a lot worse things happening in the world for us to be, you know, wanting to kill ourselves over some girls, you know.
Do you think the incident, Donnie, in the hotel in Louisville harmed the group in any way?
If it turns somebody in a different direction from us, then maybe it did, you know what I mean? It's not stopping us, you know. I think the whole incident was like a ridiculous joke anyway, you know what I mean? But I think the whole incident actually told me a lot about the world, you know what I mean? When I saw myself on the headlines of newspapers, like all around the world, over something that eventually was dropped, you know, so eventually was proven that the whole thing was a myth and blown out of proportion, it makes me wonder what everybody's priorities are. You know, when a pop singer is on the front page of newspapers all around the world for allegedly starting a fire, you know, when you got people dying, you got people fighting for human rights all around the world, and the main topic everybody wants to read about is me setting a fire or not setting a fire, that's ridiculous, you know what I mean? So if it hurt the group, hey, you know, we're still together and we're still going for ours, you know?
Are you going to stay together?
Yeah, we're going to stay together, you know? I mean, we're going to try and explore, you know, things as individuals, because, I mean, it's not like we're going to be, you know, walking into the sunset forever, you know, all five of us. I mean, we're all growing up and becoming our own people. But, you know, we're gonna try different things, and we're still going to stay together, too, you know.
And the question every young girl wants to ask, who's the biggest playboy of the group?
No, we don't have a lot of girlfriends. We're not, you know, I mean, we have a lot of girls, you know, outside and screaming for us, but we're not too crazy. You know, we know our limits and boundaries that we keep, so.
We're just people, you know what I'm saying? We're very fortunate and very blessed to be in a wonderful situation. You know, we're having a lot of success. We're traveling around the world. We're making a lot of people happy and making ourselves and our families happy, you know, but all in all, when all said and done, we're still people, we're still human beings, and we're still young men, and we're gonna do what men do, and that means doing the dishes, taking out the garbage, and playing around with women, yes.
This is the first time these adoring Australian fans have had the chance to pay their respects close up.
John, I've been waiting for you.
Although the results may be a little disappointing.
You got braces.
Eric!
If I can make a 13-year-old girl happy, what's the difference? That's not a crime, you know what I mean?
Exactly.
It's not a crime to have young fans. I'm glad that we have young fans because we can influence them and be a positive influence on them.
After all, there's nothing very new about this sort of reception. These girls' mothers probably had the same sort of deep and meaningful exchange with the Beatles.
Stupidity of letting their children come into something like this.
And their older sisters with Wham or Broz. But where there was Beatlemania and girls happy to be called Brozettes, now...
I'm so proud to be called a blockhead. You do not know how proud I am. I love him so much. I've got sheets and towels and mirrors and my watch. See my watch? I love him so much. You got the right stuff, baby.
You're the reason why I sing this song. For the five young men from the wrong side of the tracks in Boston, that blockheadedness has translated into money in the bank. Plucked from obscurity by music entrepreneur Maurice Starr, shaped, packaged, primped and produced. 5 years down the track, they're not new kids anymore, but they own the block.
Is the music more important or is the profit more important?
I think more so than that, I think, you know, individual happiness is more important.
We're pretty good with our money, and we take care of our families, which is the most important thing.
Anyway, while it worries about musical integrity come between them and this great lifestyle.
But you gotta take the good with the bad. I mean, we're on a cruise back home in Boston. It's like 20 degrees, and it's like 80, 90 degrees out here, so.
That's such hard work.
We're chilling.
We can't wait for that.
When do you think it will all end? When will new kids grow up?
You can't grow up to the public, you know what I mean? I don't think that's the issue. I don't think, you know, I could be 40 and little girls could still love me, you know what I mean?